गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास ए इंग्लिश ग्रामर। इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट वर्ब्स ऑक्सिलरीज एंड मॉडल्स एंड यूजेस ऑफ वर्ब मॉडल्स। सो सम मोर यूजेस ऑफ मॉडल्स आर गिवन हियर, विल, वुड, शैल, शुड, एंड व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ विल, वुड एंड शैल, शुड यू कैन सी हियर वन बाय वन। फर्स्ट इज विल एंड शैल आर यूज्ड टू टॉक अबाउट फ्यूचर। यू नो जनरली वी यूज will and shall to talk about future. Here you can see will is used to all the subjects, with all the subjects, all kind of first person, second person and third person we can use will, but shall is used with the first person subject in future tense. And I will never forget you, so here the use of will with the first person singular subject will is used. And my father will be 40 tomorrow. So here use of will with the singular subject. I shall be pleased to help you. And in third example I shall. So I told you shall is used with the first person subject in future tense. I and we, these are the two subjects of first person. I the singular subject and we the plural subject of first person. And shall is used with the first person subject. So to talk about the future we can use, we use will and shall. Will is used with all the subjects and shall is used with the first person subject. In second number we can use will in offer. Generally when we offer to someone for something, so in that case we use will. Like I will give you a lift to the station. So will is used with I subject here you can see, and here in this sentence we offer for something to someone. In next sentence we will put you up for the night. So will is used with first person plural subject we. So in that case to express offer we use will. In third number you can see we use will or would in offers and invitation. In offers and invitation we use will and would. So here examples are given. Here you can see will you have some more grapes. So will is used to express offer. Will you come to dinner tomorrow. So will is used to express invitation. Next third is would you like an ice cream. So that is an offer. Would is used to express offer. And fourth sentence, would you like to come for a picnic. So that is invitation, means would is used to express invitation. In this sense we can use or we use will and would to in offer to express offer and invitation. In fourth number we use will and would to ask people to do things. Both will and would are used to ask the people to do something. Like example, will you pass me the salt. So here to ask something for, to ask to the people for to do something. So will is used here. Will you pass me salt. And second is would you do me a favor. So here is the, here we are asking to the people to do something, है ना, using will and would. Dear students, here some more uses of modal verbs, of modal verbs will, would and shall, should. So you can see here fifth number, we use shall to offer to do something for someone. Here shall is also used to offer to do something for someone. Example, shall I call you a taxi. So here shall is used to offer. Shall I call you a taxi. So here we are offering to someone for something. And second example, shall I post the letters for you. Here I am offering, here I offer to someone for something. Shall I post, here I offer. to post the letter, है ना, for someone else. So in this way, sell is used to express offer for someone else. Next number, we use sell in offers, suggestion and advice. So here you can see, say like shut the windows, window, that is the offer here. And sell in what? This program, that is the suggestion. He is taking the suggestion. And yes, he is asking for suggestion. So sell we record this program, he is asking for suggestion. Means he is demanding the suggestion. And next is, which sari sell I buy? Which sari sell I buy? That is the advice. So he is asking for advice. And in first sentence, sell I shut the windows, he is asking for offer. So that is, in that case, sell is used to express offer, suggestion and advice. Next number, should. Should is used to talk about obligation and to give advice. Should is also used to give advice and to talk about obligation. You can see the example here. We should obey the laws. So we should obey the laws here. That is the use of should. We should work harder and we should change friends at Gudur. Gudur is a place. So here should is used to talk about obligation and to give advice or to take advice. Next number 8, we also use should to express probability. Means to express probability, we also use should. She should be at home now. She should be at home now. Next, she should be over 30. So here that is the probability, possibility, है ना? And using you, having used should, we can express about the probability. Dear students, you see here uses of modals must or ending. So the uses of must or ending, we use must. Use of must here. Must is used to talk about necessity and obligation. So what is necessity and obligation? Necessity means the thing which is necessary, or obligation means यहाँ पे है कर्तव्य, means काम. So we use must to talk about necessity or obligation. So we must be honest. So that is necessity or obligation. We must be honest. हमको honest होना चाहिए. That is necessity. That is our obligation. And you must give up smoking. So you must give up smoking. That is obligation. I must get up at 5 o'clock. So all these sentences are of necessity and obligation, and must is used in these sentences. Next number, must is used when the obligation comes from speaker, and whereas had to is used when the obligation comes from outside. Means जब obligation speaker के लिए speaker से आता है तो वहां पे मस्ट का यूज करते हैं, और जब ऑब्लिगेशन किसी और की तरफ से स्पीकर के लिए आता है तो वहां पे हम हैड टू का यूज करते हैं. यू कैन सी द एग्जांपल हियर. आई मस्ट बी ऑन अ डाइट. हियर द स्पीकर इज सेइंग फॉर हिमसेल्फ, आई मस्ट बी ऑन अ डाइट फ्रॉम स्पीकर. मीन्स मस्ट इज यूज्ड एंड हियर द स्पीकर इज सेइंग फॉर हिमसेल्फ. So that's why must is used. And in the next second sentence, I have to be on a diet. So there is no difference in the sentence, but the difference is that this statement came from the outside, means from other person for the speaker. So when the statement comes from the outside or from the other person to the speaker or for the speaker, so in that case, had to is applied. And when the statement comes from the speaker, in that case, for the speaker, in that case we use must. And next, use of need not or don't. So need not and don't have to, don't have to. Use of need not and don't have to are used to say that something is not necessary. When something is not necessary, in that case we use the model need not and don't have to. You can see the example. You need not or don't have to meet him. Means जब कोई चीज बहुत जरूरी नहीं होती है, that is not necessary, in that case we use need not and don't have to. Means you need not meet him or you don't have to meet him. So in this way we can use all these models must, ought and need.